Jella Gramat, may kilala ka bang JP Samson, yung may-ari ng West Cars, yung dinala sa kay Alice Go?
I cannot remember, sir. Hindi ko ma-recall kung may kilala kong JP Samson, but as far as I know, wala kong kakilala, sir.
General Karamat, you're under oath, ha?
Yes, sir.
I'm telling you. I'll be showing you a picture of John Patrick Samson and you together.
According to my former command group here, we have a board resolution, sir. And I just want to present a simple logic here, sir. Accusing me of whimsically.
Mr. Chair, General Karamat.
Yes, sir.
We're not accusing you here. Be careful of your words. We're not accusing you here. We're asking questions, and that is our job. Remember that.
Noted po, Mr. Chairman, sir.
Why are you accusing me? Sama kami rito eh.
I just wanted to find out why all of the sudden napaltan agad si Albuyacao. And as a matter of fact, kanina sinasabi mo that there is a certain Colonel Bernabusita Alejandro also?
Yes, Mr. Chair. After operation ng CIDG-3 headed by Colonel Alejandro, the following day, nirelieve din po siya eh.
So, ang nagrelieve dito during that time ng February 2, 2023 is not CPNP Marbil. This is during the time of Acorda. And who is the CIDG chief during this time?
All this time, General Karamat.
General Karamat, siya na naman. General Karamat, you have to stay here. Sit down. So, dalawang relief ang ginawa mo. Isa nung February 2 with Colonel Alejandro, and the other one is with Colonel Buyacao. After all the successful operation, what I heard from Congressman Busita, parehong-pareho that nag-operate, naging successful, tapos nire-relieve. Pero, different CPNP. Am I correct, General Karamat?
Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman, sir. No, sir. I was not, to clarify the matter, sir, I was not the one who relieved Colonel Buyacao. But in the case of Colonel Alejandro...
Wait. General, ikaw ang chief CIDG.
Yes, sir.
So, it's command responsibility. Ikaw ang pumirma, pero may utos sa taas. Ganun ba yan?
That's correct again, Your Honor.
Okay. So now, going back to the interpellation of Congressman Busita, we are just wondering, dahil itong panahon ni Alejandro, February 2, 2023, ang CPNP dito ay si Acorda. Am I correct?
That's correct, Your Honor.
And during the relief of Colonel George Buyacao, it was already CPNP Marbil.
Correct, Your Honor.
Correct. So now, and during these two incidents, you are the chief CIDG. Am I correct?
Correct, Your Honor.
Ayan. Oh, so, ikaw yung common denominator dito sa pag-relieve ng dalawang grupong ito. Ang tanong natin nga kanina, tinatanong ko rin, why is it that after the successful operation, after a day, nirelieve natin si Colonel Alejandro at ito namang si Colonel George Buyacao ay nirelieve din during your time? Why?
Thank you, Your Honor. Let me clarify my position, sir.
Go ahead.
In the case of Colonel Alejandro, the cause of his relief has no connection to the operation of Banban. Before the operation in Banban last February 2023, Colonel Alejandro was already informed of the impending reshuffle of all the regional, of some regional chief of the CIDG. So he was informed already before the raid in Bamban happened, sir. So it was a normal rotation of all my regional chiefs because as a commander then, newly assigned commander or director of CIDG, I have to put in place my commanders whom I have the trust and confidence, sir.
Okay. So, General Karamat, kailan ka po na-appoint bilang chief CIDG?
January 1, 2023.
And when was the operation of this, the ano, the ng operation doon sa Bamban?
February 2023.
Wait, General Karamat.
Yes, sir.
February 1 nagkaroon ng operation, and then February 2 na-relieve si Colonel Alejandro.
That's correct, Your Honor.
Si Alejandro, ang position niya during that time is
Regional Chief of CIDG Region 3, sir.
Okay, Region 3. I will tell you, General Karamat, if you're going to relieve all these people, no, and assigning them to the different parts of this country, there is a pending case. So yung pending case ito, nandito sa korte, di ba? Asan yung kasong ito? Sa Bulacan? Paano sila makakabalik para to monitor the case that was filed against this, ano, against these perpetrators? Yeah. And assigning them, no, parang I think is not to the best interest of the organization. Unless there is a clandestine, no, effort to really put the case on the garbage. Para kung may nakikita ang mga missing link dito, eh, hindi ko talaga makomprehend kung bakit yun nirelieve, eh, yung mga tao, pagkatapos imbis na bigyan natin sila ng pabuya, di ba? Kasi alam nyo, ako, hindi ako polis, pero I know for a fact that kapag napunta ka sa NCR, parang ano yan, eh, level up, eh. Pero putting your people outside, no, after the complete successful operation, that will put a doubt on the transfer. General Karamat, may kilala ka bang JP Samson?
I cannot remember, sir. Wala akong kakilala, sir.
I'll be showing you a picture of John Patrick Samson and you together. But pictures, hindi naman magsasabi yan na meron kang involvement. But what I'm trying to say is kilala mo. I will send it to you, General
yes,
Karamat.
Sir, yes,
because
sir.
What we wanted is to ferret out the truth. And I will try to give it to you or you to find out kung nare-recall mo yung si John Patrick Samson. Si John Patrick Samson is the owner of the West Cars that was used by Alice Go doon sa kanyang mga sa Pogo at doon sa kanya sa Banban. And that's the reason why I'm asking you, I'm just testing you kung kilala mo. Tapos sinasabi mo hindi mo siya ma-recall. But now, are you going to tell us that you can recall him already?
Not all, Mr. Chairman, sir. As a CIDG director, many were inviting you, but it does not mean na yung kasama ko doon sa picture, kilala ko. We are just like politicians. Anybody can take a picture with us, sir.
General Karamat, we are not trying to tell you that you have involvement. Ang sinasabi lang namin kanina.
Wait.
I'm still talking, you know?
Yes, sir.
Ang sinasabi lang, tinatanong ko lang, kung may kanina, tinatanong ko kung may kilala ka. Sabi ko, kaya nga pinakikita ko sa iyong picture, ngayon nare-recall mo na siya.
Yes, sir.
O yan. O, di na-recall mo na, kilala mo na, that's it.
I just met him in one of the occasions, sir, but okay. I do not know him personally, sir.
You don't know him personally?
Yes, sir.
Oh, this is one of the occasions that you have be with him?
Yes, sir.
That's it.
Yes, sir.
Wala naman po kami sinasabing iba dito, eh. Ang tinatanong ko lang kung may kilala kayong JP Samson.
Your question is kung kilala ko, sir. I cannot recall, sir, dahil sa dami ng nakikilala
kaya
ko,
nga,
sir.
And then I
cannot
answer
recall
back.
Their name already,
Karamat,
sir.
Wait. Then I answer back. Then I said, pakikita ko para at least ma-recall mo. Okay? So picture, sasabi na na-encounter mo siya. And that's the reason why we will be inviting over also John Patrick Samson, yung pong owner ng West Car. Ayan. Para malaman po natin yung mga sinasabi natin lahat dito. And again, hindi ako. Babalik ko na po kay Colonel Busita.
General Bakay, sir. Yung pong Senior Officers Placement Board, ang secretary po ba niyan ang PICOD Chief? Tama po ba?
Mr. Chair, just to maybe shorten the inquiries on this matter, Mr. Chair, kung paano po nakarating sa table ko yung memo na yun, we have here the Senior Executive Assistant of the Chief PNP. Siya po yung nakatanggap ng order to issue. I would like to correct also, Mr. Chair, the memo I signed is not a relief order of Colonel Buyacao, but an assignment of Police Colonel Ana as the Director, as the RFU NCR of CIDG, Mr. Chair. But necessarily, of course, kasi ilalagay si Colonel Anan, it will follow na susunod na papalitan si Colonel Buyacao. So, Mr. Chair, if you allow us, nandito po si Sir former Senior Executive Assistant Chief PNP, who received the order for the DPRM to initiate the installation of Police Colonel Ana as CIDG NCR. If you will allow, Mr.
Wait,
Chair.
General Bakay, if I may, Congressman Busita. So, ang sinasabi mo, General Bakay, it was the order of the Executive Assistant of the Chief PNP that Ana will replace Buyacao. Pero alam nyo na mayroong accomplishment si Buyacao. Alam ng Chief PNP na mayroong nagawang maganda si Colonel Buyacao. So why not assign Colonel Ana to other position? Why specifically yung kay Buyacao while Buyacao have accomplished something?
If I may, Mr. Chair, during the accomplished the operation in Bamban, the Chief PNP was former Chief PNP Acorda. That was in the month of March. Umupo po na Chief PNP April 1 si current now.
So sino nag-order na palitan si Buyacao ni Ana?
Si General Marbil, Mr. Chair.
Yes, that 'yun ang tinatanong natin.
Yes.
Because I think it will cause some demoralization on those officers who have successfully, no, conducted operations like this one, and then suddenly papalitan niyo siya. Don't you think it's like improper for the PNP to do such changing of guards?
My apologies, Mr. Chair, but again, of course, the designation is of course within the powers of Chief PNP under Section 26.
Oh, sige. General Rakay, I got it.